I have returned. I've gotten myself some hot water and lemon. So that I hopefully won't cough so much. I've angled the camera down a little bit more so that you can see the whole painting instead of just parts of it. So hopefully that'll help. And, well, I realized that I had scooched my thread up my sleeve when I did dishes this morning and forgot to pull it back down. I made it pretty loose so it kind of slides up there.
Don't chew on the sheepskin, you cheeky monkey.
I just gave the little man his breakfast, so he's all full of, post-breakfast energy. Well, that's good. Okay. So, like I said, I've picked some of that. I've mixed some light yellow, and I'm going into more warm colors this time. I was going to do three colors in white, but I decided to do three colors in yellow. These two look the same, because they pretty much are. One is red ochre, and one is burnt sienna. So it's basically just warm, really warm, good, sunshiny, feel-good colors in this one. Because it's just sort of what I'm feeling for right now. After the last layer, I sat with the painting for a little bit, had a look at it. And I was really enjoying just the overall feel of the whole thing. It feels really good so far. I did also notice that I want to pick out over here, which is very interesting. I found when I stepped back, I discovered another person with their head down right here. So the thing that I thought was a leaf looks more to be a people. So I might actually end up having two people in this painting. I'm not sure if she seems pretty sad, so I'm not sure if she's holding, I'm not sure if she's got her face in her hands, or what's going on. But I also noticed, and that's one of the good things when you start to get into this layer, this is what you start doing, is really sitting with it in between layers. You can journal in between layers now too, as opposed to just at the end of a session. I assume in the end of session one, you would have journaled for a little bit and felt into what happened in the first session. How the colors made you feel, what colors you were craving. I did notice actually, and while we were talking before about the images from the original inner landscapes, and then also from Ripples of Memory, how there came up the infant's face in the top corner. Here, the thing that I made before, the little, oval that I outlined with the green that still has some of the pink from previous layers, also appears to be outside of a round belly, which I thought was quite interesting. And then I still don't know where her face is at, but I'm just basically the parts of it that I can see now, I'm just gonna highlight. I'm just gonna feel into those pieces. And the same as we did in the previous dark layer, we're gonna go through and find those things that are interesting to us so far and start pulling them out. Because we're still finding subconscious bits of information that popped up from that previous layer. So obviously with this one, because I was talking about and probably already thinking about the images that came in Ripples of Memory, it feels as though this image came through and it was completely without intention. Like I didn't think I was consciously thinking about that, but apparently I was. So I'm not going to judge myself on that. I'm not going to think to myself, why was I thinking about that? It doesn't matter. Just that I was, and that it came through. And that's, it's part of my inner landscape. It's part of what made me me over the years. And whether I've come to terms with everything in my life or not, doesn't matter. I don't have to come to terms with it now either. But it's an exploration of what's in my head. What is part of my own inner landscape. And that is what we're dealing with here. That's the whole reason we're here. Is to go into that and see what we see. That's the whole thing. And look at that. I'm just gonna take this line that I really like from before and follow it, because I feel like it goes further. I feel like it kind of goes that way. And again, I'm not trying to make it be something. I am just following what interests me, what pops out, what seems to bring me any sort of messages or ideas. I'm wondering why that popped up. But yeah, that's really interesting to me. Anyway. And I'm just going to go around the painting and find different spots that feel interesting to me. Unusual. And it's kind of funny that she's light and that one's dark. And this one looks more feminine and that one looks more masculine. So these are things that you'll start to notice that will come up. And they'll start to get you thinking. You'll start wondering where that's coming from, what that's all about. And that's where the journaling process will come into it, because you'll actually get to start to interpret these things. And you may notice different thought patterns that will come up, different thought patterns that have come up previously, things that you might not have really thought about, things that you might not have thought actually bothered you that do bother you. There's all sorts of interesting things that happen. And that leaf I loved so much, now I'm getting rid of him. I liked him, but he's served his purpose to give me an understanding that there was a shape there. So I'm just gonna go that way with that. And this will be the part that will start becoming really interesting, because you'll start to find shapes. Language, there's words that might come out again. I feel like this is doing something. It just keeps extending. This doorway keeps getting bigger and bigger, which is quite fascinating to me. Not sure what that's all about, but it keeps extending. It's almost like a doorway within a doorway, which is kind of interesting. But I'm just going to go with it. I'm not going to try and figure it out right now. The interpretation process comes after. And I mean, some of it, you might actually get some insights while you're doing it into, you know, what was going on in your head while you were doing it at first. And that's totally fine. If something comes to you, that's great. If it doesn't, don't worry about it. Just keep following your brush. Keep seeing where it goes. Keep following it into wherever it takes you. Because it could take you into separate layers. Mine's taking me into some almost ripples, it feels like, which is interesting. And you can see I'm probably going to lose most of this corner of the painting underneath this light color. And that's fine. Totally fine. I'm okay with that. And that's why I keep saying don't be too attached to what comes before. Because it will change and it'll keep changing. It's going to keep changing so much as you go. and there's no way to know how much it'll change or what will change, what will come and what will go. So just be in the process. Don't try to think too much, which is hard. I understand. I'm telling myself just as much as I'm telling you. Because for me, it's equally as difficult to remember not to try and force things. And I'm just going to follow this. I like that one little bit of dark right up close to where that was. And then I'm feeling like this gets lighter somehow. Though I'm not yet sure how or how far. So I'm just going to let that be like that for now. And it'll always get chaotic and then back to not chaotic and then chaotic again. So just expect that that will happen, because it will. And that's not a problem. You just kind of have to assume that it's going to get, because that's just like our minds. Our minds get chaotic and then they calm because they figure something out, and then they get chaotic again and they get calm. And the puppy's looking at me as though he wants to go out for his after breakfast walk. He's like, why? Why are we doing this? Why aren't we walking? Which I completely understand. And I noticed that some of the feelings I was having about it having gone so dark, I don't know, it wasn't really bothering me. I was just sort of not feeling it as much with it going darker. So I think that's why I was so drawn to the yellow again. Because I really want it to go to a lighter place again. Because that would please me. Yeah, you good boy. Yeah, open up here. Yeah. I know. It's part of why you're so adorable. If you just talk. I love you. I'm going to go on this side of the flower again. Of the Narcissus pod. It's like saying Narcissus. It's fun. And so this feels like it's going somewhere too. Quite interesting. This big doorway. I don't usually like having big things right in the middle of my paintings, just aesthetically speaking. Unless I'm doing, you know, a muse or something, because then it makes sense. But this feels right somehow. So I'm just going to keep going with that. Yes, 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 yes. And as you can hear, I'm going to have to pause the video now and go and walk the puppy. So I will be back. And we shall paint some more in a few minutes. Yeah, I'm coming. He's so bossy. Did you just fluffy? You did. Cheeky. So I will see you in a few minutes after I walked this tiny bossy beast.